Jai Hind, I'm leading Flight Cadet Reshma CC, representing Karnataka and Goa Directorate, 6 Karnataka Air Squadron NCC Mangaluru, NCC A-Wing Flight A. In this session, we will be discussing about the topic navigation. So let's begin with the presentation. Air navigation is the art of guiding an aircraft through the air so that it arrives at a desired position at a pre-calculated time. Air navigation differs from a surface navigation in several ways, such as the aircraft travels at relatively high speeds, leaving less time to calculate their position en route. Aircraft also normally cannot stop in mid-air to ascertain their position at will. There are some terms which are frequently used in navigation. Before studying terms and definitions, I'll just let you know the requirements of navigation. A number of times, pilot may be called upon to navigate the aircraft himself, especially in the aircraft types where no navigation is provided, or in a single-seat aircraft. Hence, a thorough knowledge of the art of navigation is a must for a pilot. Since the pilot has the primary duty of flying the aircraft, it would not be possible for him to carry out the detailed task of a professional navigator in usage of plotting tables, computers, charts, etc. He, however, has to be skilled in map reading and mental DR in order to navigate accurately. There are two flight rules, visual flight rules, instrument flight rules. Let's go with terms and definitions. The shape of the Earth is a spheroid, diameter at the poles is a little less than diameter at equator, but we usually consider it a perfect sphere. A great circle. A circle or disk which splits the Earth into equal halves passing through the center is called great circle. A circle or disk which cuts the Earth into unequal halves doesn't pass through the center is called small circle. Equator. A great circle which is perpendicular to the Earth's axis is called equator. It divides Earth into the northern and southern hemisphere. Meridian. Great circles which pass through the poles indicates north-south direction. Parallels of latitudes. Small circles which are parallel to the equator, perpendicular to meridians, represents east-west directions. Poles. The extreme ends of the diameter of the Earth through which the Earth's axis passes. Latitude, meridian distance from equator, represented as angles, indicated by north or south in relation to equator. Longitude, the angle between a meridian and the Greenwich meridian, expressed in angles, indicated by east or west relative to Greenwich meridian. Rhomb line, curved line which cuts all meridians at the end at the same angle is called rhomb line. Examples of rhomb line. Axis of rotation, imaginary line through which the Earth rotates. It is inclined at 23.5 degree to vertical. Measurement of direction. To fly, a navigator needs a reference line to determine the direction. They are measured clockwise from 0 degree to 360 degree. Important terms. True north. Geographic north pole is called true north. All meridians converge here. Magnetic north. The point to which a compass needle points is called true north. Earth's magnetic field converges at this point. Compass north, the direction pointed by an aircraft compass under the influence of other magnetized components. Variation, difference in angle between true north and magnetic north. Deviation, difference in angle between magnetic north and compass north. Isogonals, lines joining points of equal variation. Heading, the direction in which the nose of the aircraft is pointed, considered in relation to north. Track, the actual direction in which the aircraft is traveling in reference to the ground. Heading versus track representation. Track required, the track the aircraft must follow to fly from one point to another. Track made good is the actual track the aircraft is following. Drift, angle between heading and track made good. Track required versus TMG versus heading representing. Distance, linear displacement between two points. Statue mile, 5280 feet, which is equal to 1 mile. Kilometer, 1000 meters, considered 1 by 10,000 of average distance between equator and a pole. Nautical mile, an arc on a great circle which forms an angle of 1 minute. Nautical mile, 1 nautical mile is equal to 6080 feet. Wind velocity, wind speed along a specific direction. Speed, rate of change of position, expressed as nautical mile per hour or knots, kilometer per hour, miles per hour. Airspeed, speed of an aircraft flying through the air regardless of wind speed. Ground speed, speed in relation to the ground. Ground position, point on the ground beneath the aircraft. Pinpoint, ground position of the aircraft determined by observation. Air position, position of an aircraft in air assuming no wind. Dead reckoning position, dead reckoning position is the position deduced from previously gathered information. Fix, ground position determined by methods other than dead reckoning. Scale is the relation between the length of a line drawn on the map with those positioned in the real world. Three methods of representing, statement in words, the scale is represented verbally. Graduated scale line depicted at the bottom of a map as a scale. Representative fraction, statement in words depicted mathematically, calculated as scale is equal to chart length per distance on earth. Example, 1 cm on the map represents 5 lakh cm on earth. Large scale, greater detail but covers less distance. Small scale, less detail but covers a larger distance. Scale is chosen depending on distance, height, speed, terrain. Small scale versus large scale picture. Map, a pictorial representation of Earth's surface drawn on a flat surface. The sphere of Earth is represented on a flat surface by various projections. Requirements when making a map, rhomb line must be straight, great circles must be straight, latitudes and longitudes must be easy to represent, sheets should fit well, angles on the earth's surface must be represented accurately, scale should be fixed, area should appear in the real shape. Equal areas on the earth should be shown as equal areas on map. Relief is the representation of ground elevation on a map, essential for safe flight, usually displayed as a combination of two or more methods of the following. Contours of form lines, hill shading, layer tinting, spot elevation, hachuring. Contours, lines drawn on the map joining points of equal elevation, points of approximate elevation shown as broken lines. Spot elevation, The height points are represented by a point with the elevation shown, used to supplement contours. Map picture. Hashing. Hashes and short lines on the map radiating from higher ground to lower, usually used when detailed information is not needed. Layer tinting. The areas between contours are tinted or colored to indicate relief, usually getting darker with higher elevation. Hill shading. Higher ground is represented by shadows which they would cast in real life. This gives an appearance of depth to the map, most effective to show elevation difference in flatter areas. Map legend. An explanation of the symbols shown on the map. Requirements for good map reading: good pre-flight planning, convenient flying parameters such as height, speed, direction, paying attention to ETA, estimated time of arrival, good orientation and anticipation. A map should show natural or terrain features as well as man-made cultural features. Relief, water, hills, railway lines and roads make reading maps easier. With this, we have come to the end of the session. So far, we have covered what is navigation, requirements of navigation, terms and definitions used in navigation, measurement of directions and its definition, scale, three methods of representing scale, large versus small scale, map, requirements of map, relief, contours and form lines, spot elevation, hashing, layer tinting, hill shading, map legends, requirement of map reading, features in a map, map reading aids. Thank you. Jai Hind.